In 1862, Brahms was staying with a friend, the composer Albert Dietrich, in Cologne after a music festival in the city. It was there and then that he began composing his first sonata for a solo instrument and piano, the cello sonata in E minor. Nearby, in the town of Münster am Stein, Clara Schumann was taking the baths. Dietrich recalled a happy time, he and Johannes composing, walking in the countryside, and Clara playing the piano to them in the evenings. Dietrich wrote to his wife, "The longer I am with Brahms, the more my affection and esteem for him increase. His nature is equally lovable, cheerful, and deep." Three years later, Brahms wrote the fugal third movement to complete the sonata, a work that shows his deep sympathy with the character of the cello and its huge expressive range. Brahms' piano writing, often thickly textured and emphasizing the lower registers, may have created problems for him in balancing the keyboard and string instruments. But he solved them brilliantly. The E minor sonata and its later companion in F major are still two of the cornerstones of the cello repertoire. Here is an extract from the passionate first movement in my new recording. The cello is played by Truls Mork. Many years later, Brahms referred to the time with Robert and Clara Schumann in Düsseldorf as his Werther years, and there were definite parallels between the young composer and Goethe's sensitive young hero, who fell in love with the fiancée of another man. During that period, Brahms had written to Joachim, "I often have to restrain myself forcibly from just quietly putting my arm around her, and even, I don't know, it seems to me so natural that she could not misunderstand. I think I can no longer love an unmarried girl, at least I have quite forgotten about them. They but promise heaven, while Clara shows it revealed to us." We may never know just what happened in Düsseldorf, but as Nancy Reich writes in her biography of Clara, it is clear that from the beginning, their relationship was far more than a mere infatuation. Meeting and loving Clara Schumann was to affect the course of Brahms's life. "Dear Clara," he later wrote her in a letter, "permit a poor outsider to tell you today that he thinks of you with the same reverence he always did, and from the bottom of his heart wishes you, the dearest of all persons to him, everything good and much love. You and your husband are the most beautiful experience of my life and represent its greatest treasure and its noblest moments." In their way, these three very different musical personalities and the extraordinary bond that developed between them allow us to understand that love is an infallible gift, the most intimate freedom that one may have towards another, a law whose secret was revealed by Rilke in his Requiem. "For this is wrong, if anything is wrong, not to enlarge the freedom of a love, with all the inner freedom one can summon. We need, in love, to practice only this, letting each other go."